As mentioned in a previous video, Drupal's more like a framework. Straight out of the box, it doesn't do a whole lot. To make Drupal do more, you must enable functionality. And so this next link on the administration toolbar, Extend, is where you go to enable new functionality. Early on, when you begin to build your site, you'll frequently visit Extend. Go ahead and click on Extend now. This gives us an overview of all the Drupal modules available on our site. Think of modules as functionality features. There are modules that come with Drupal, called core modules, and there are modules that you can get from Drupal.org, called contributed modules, and there are modules you or your team can create, called custom modules. In this course, we use core and contributed modules for our needs. Custom module development has its own course. One thing I want to point out right away is to resist the temptation to install modules through Drupal's user interface with this Install New Module button. If you are using Composer to manage site dependencies like we are, then you should always use Composer to install modules. We'll install a module using Composer later on in this video. Again, this video is just introductory. On this Extend page, you can see what functionality has been enabled or not enabled just by looking at the check marks. Currently, every module enabled here has been enabled by default with the Drupal standard installation we did earlier in the Drupal installation video. So scrolling back up to the top, let's filter for media modules to enable them. We're looking for media and media library. Always be sure to read the description of each module so you know what you are enabling. Media manages the creation, configuration, and display of media items, and media library enhances the media list, making it easier to work with media. We will work with media in detail later on in this course. Note that there can be some ambiguity in the term install. It's used both to mean install the code to your server, and install also means to enable functionality. Keep this in mind as you will likely encounter the word install again when talking to others about your Drupal site. Go ahead and check both media and media library, and when you are ready, click on the install button near the bottom to enable the media functionality. Fantastic! Now that we have enabled the core media functionality, let's briefly see the media functionality that has been enabled. Visit the content section in the administration toolbar. Notice we now have a media tab that was not there initially. Further, if we click and visit the structure section, we see that there is a new area called media types. Again, we'll focus on media later on in this course. To conclude this video, let's install a contributed module using Composer. In a new tab, visit drupal.org/project/admin_toolbar. The admin toolbar is one of the most useful modules you will come across because it makes it so efficient to navigate the administrative areas of your Drupal site. Feel free to read the description at your leisure. Scrolling down, under project information, you can see that many, many sites use this module. You'll likely see that there are various versions of the module for you to enable. Most commonly, you can install modules using the generic Composer require command, like is demonstrated here above in the documentation. Get the code like any other module, Composer require Drupal/admin_toolbar. Admin_toolbar is the machine name of this module, and you can verify it by looking at the Drupal.org URL, which ends in project/admin_toolbar. But just in case you need to download a specific version of a module, an efficient way to do that is if you go back down to the version listings, if you click on the actual version, for example, such as 3.0.0, Drupal.org will provide you with the syntactically correct Composer command to use. Recall that this caret 3.0 instructs Composer to download and install the 3.0 branch of the module. For comparison, if we go back and click on the 8.2 version, the Composer command is provided appropriately with a caret 2.4. Going back to the description page, for us, using the generic Composer command will always work. It's likely it will always work for you too. So I'll copy this Composer require Drupal admin toolbar command and paste it into my terminal window. Here in the terminal, I'm at my local site directory, and if I paste the Composer command directly, I'll get an error because I don't have Composer installed locally on this machine. However, since I am using DDEV and it does supply Composer in its container running my site, if I prepend the comment with DDEV, Composer will install the recommended branch of this module, which in this case is the 3.0 branch, like so. Super! Now that the code of the contributed admin toolbar module has been installed, if we head back to our Drupal site, click on Extend again in the administrative menu, if we scroll down, we'll see a new grouping called Administration. And here is the newly installed admin toolbar module and its submodules. Click on Admin Toolbar, Admin Toolbar Extra Tools, and the Admin Toolbar Search. Once you have those three checked, scroll down to the Install button at the bottom. Click Install. Nice! After you have enabled the Admin Toolbar modules, hover over the Administrative menu. You'll likely experience a drop-down menu which makes it much more efficient to navigate your Drupal site. Congratulations on achieving an overview of the Extend area, which is used to enable additional functionality of your Drupal site. Well done on enabling the core media modules and for using Composer to bring in the admin toolbar functionality. Every step we have taken so far is setting us up for success in the build-out of our Waterfall Handbook site. I'll meet you in the next video. Happy learning!